चलो।
गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट एसी जनरेटर। सो कंस्ट्रक्शन इज सिमिलर टू डीसी टू द मोटर, बट हियर इन प्लेस ऑफ बैटरी वी हैव अ गैल्वेनोमीटर। सो वी हैव आर्मेचर व्हिच इज केप्ट इनसाइड बिटवीन द टू मैग्नेट्स, ओके, दैट इज कॉल्ड फील्ड मैग्नेट। देन वी हैव स्लिप रिंग्स बिकॉज इट इज एसी जनरेटर। सो इन एसी जनरेटर वी हैव स्लिप रिंग्स, बट इफ वी हैव डीसी जनरेटर देन इट विल बी स्प्लिट रिंग्स। Now these two are brushes and then the outer circuit is connected with a galvanometer. Now here, suppose we are rotating this coil in the magnetic field. Okay, this side is moving this side and this will move out. So that means this is rotating in the clockwise direction. So now in that case, the flux linked with the coil will change, and due to the change in flux, a current will induce in it. Now what will be the direction of induced current? That we can find out by using Fleming's right hand rule. Now the direction of magnetic field will be from north to south like this, and the motion of the coil is inside. So we will have to right hand, and we will have to put it like this. Okay, it will move, the coil will move inside, magnetic field will be towards this side, so current is downward. So here the current is downward in this arm AB. Now in CD apply the same thing, magnetic field here, and it will come out, so the current is upward. So here the current is upward. So in outer circuit the current moves from AB through this brush B1 and to B2. So in this case the direction of current will be from B1 to B2, and the galvanometer will show deflection in this direction. Now suppose after half rotation the AB and CD, they will change their places, they will change their sides. So now AB will come to this side and CD will come to this side, and the coil rotates in clockwise direction. It continues to be rotating in clockwise direction. Now the direction of current in both the arms will interchange. Here the direction of current is downward and here it is upward. But in outer circuit the direction of current, if we look at the direction of current, then this current moves inside and then it will come to this. Okay, it will follow this path and then there, here, and then since it is a conducting ring, so it will follow like this, and through brushes the current will move from B2 to B1, and then through this, from here it will move like this and then into this arm. So here the direction of current in the outer circuit will be from B2 to B1, and the galvanometer will show deflection in right direction. So you can observe that after half rotation the direction of current changes. Initially it was from B1 to B2, and after half rotation it will be from B2 to B1. So that is about AC. So that's why we can produce AC current. And if we want to get a DC generator, then simply we have to replace these slip rings with split rings. So AC mein hamare paas kya hoti hai? In AC we have slip rings. And if we want DC, then we will have to make split rings. Okay, all the principle working is same. So in this case, you have to check one thing, that this arm AB will move inside this ring during the rotation, and this arm CD will rotate in this. So that's why it will come after rotation, it will come like this, it will move like this, and then after half rotation, it will come here. AB will come here. And CD, initially it was here. It goes here, then when the coil rotates, it comes like this, and then it will, after half rotation, it will be this side. So this is all the working of AC generator.